بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. Today, inshallah, we will talk about Zakariya. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala spoke about him. He's a prophet. And Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala spoke about him in Surah Maryam, in Surah Ali Imran, in Surah Al-Anbiya, and in Surah Al-An'am. So there are four places in Quran where Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala spoke about him. First, we have to know that Zakariya alayhi salam was like from the, like he is like a grandchild, or like let's say like grandfather up to the grandfathers, like 15 grandfathers up or back to Sulaiman alayhi salam and to Dawood alayhi salam. So he is from the descendants of Sulaiman alayhi salam. So if we go back after Sulaiman, wa alaykum as-salam wa rahmatullah, after Sulaiman, sorry? The light is on. Which car? What's the color?
I think it's purple.
Oops. So Zakariya alayhi salam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala spoke about him in Surah Ali Imran, ayah number 37. وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. كَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا. He took care of her. So he was the carer of her. Who is her? She is Maryam alayha salam. So inshallah we will talk about the details of how, like, why did he take care of her and everything about Maryam. The story of Maryam alayha salam will be after talking about Zakariya and his son Yahya. So now we are talking about Zakariya. He was the carer of Maryam. Maryam lived in a room which is connected to Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa, and she was dedicated only to worship Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. So she was in Al-Masjid Al-Aqsa. Who took care of her? Zakariya alayhi salam. Of course, he's a prophet. He's a messenger from Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. He always prayed to Allah. He always made dua. And he always remembered Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. But one event happened that touched his heart. Zakariya alayhi salam did not have children. And he asked Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for children all his life. He's a prophet, so he always asked Allah to grant him a child. But he did not have a child and he became old. He became old, how old is he? We don't know. Some say like he is definitely older than 70. Was he 80, 90? Like, he was old and he did not have children. His wife was Aqim. Aqim in Arabic is the lady who does not have children. So since they were married, they did not have children. So the problem was in his wife. His wife had a problem physically that she couldn't become pregnant to have a child for him. But he always, subhanAllah, had hope to have a child because he knew that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is able with his will to grant him a child. So he always prayed and asked Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for a child until one day. He used to go to Maryam alayha salam, bring her food and check on her. She's always remembering Allah. She is always there. She does not leave that place except rarely. And she's always worshipping Allah and remembering him. So one day, he entered the room where she's worshipping Allah. And he found food already there. And he was shocked. I am the one who brings you food. So where did this come from? He was very surprised. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala spoke about this in Surah Ali Imran, وَكَفَّلَهَا زَكَرِيَّا.
Zakariya took care of her, Maryam عليها السلام. كلما دخل عليها زكريا المحراب, every time Zakariya went to her room, المحراب is the private room. She made it where she lived only for worshipping Allah. Every time he goes to bring her food, he finds food there already. قال يا مريم, he said, مريم أنا لك هذا. Where did you have this from? Where did it come from? Who brought it? She said, قالت هو من عند الله. It is from Allah تبارك وتعالى. إن الله يرزق من يشاء. Allah grants whomever he wills بغير حساب, without limit, from a place that you do not even expect. You expect to have money from your job. You don't have money from the job. You have money from somewhere else, like this, subhanAllah. So where you do not expect, provision comes. Allah gives provision, whatever it is, to whomever he wills. He gives to some people to examine their, if they will thank, and he doesn't give some people to examine them if they are patient or not. So in this case, she found food. She doesn't know. She will be praying, and when she finishes praying, she looks and the food is there. Subhanallah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala brings her the food. How? She even doesn't know how. She finds it after she finishes praying. Or she wakes up and finds food waiting for her. Even some scholars said there will be some fruits which are not from that season, because there are some seasoning fruits, some in summer and some in winter, and they will find fruits from winter in summer in her room. And he was so surprised. So when she said to him that this is from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, Allah gives whomever he wishes, he wills. Here Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala spoke about this in Surah Maryam, the similar ayat. Now I will be talking about ayat from Surah Maryam and ayat from Ali Imran, the same thing, but in different ayat. Here Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says in Surah Maryam, from ayah number 1, kaf ha ya ain sad, dhikru rahmati rabbika abdahu Zakariya. Dhikru rahmati rabbika. Now Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying, mentioning the mercy of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala upon Zakariya, his slave, and upon everybody else. We know that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is merciful, but unfortunately we do not feel it sometimes. Sometimes, sisters, we get distracted. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying in here, mentioning the mercy of Allah upon his slave Zakariya. What happened to Zakariya? Which mercy? He became old. His wife did not have children for him. And his wife is old and she doesn't have children. Where is mercy in that? We human beings do not know. Where is the mercy? Maybe if has a child, maybe his child will be a problem for him. Maybe he will give him a hard time. No one knows, subhanAllah, what would happen if he had children before this time. And in here, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, وَرَحْمَتِي وَسِعَتْ كُلَّ شَيْءٍ. My mercy embraced everything. My mercy reached everything in this life. So we have mercy from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, but sometimes we forget. Sometimes we get distracted, focusing on something not important, feeling that, where is the mercy of Allah? I am abandoned. I have nothing good in my life. We forget good things in our lives. Subhanallah. We are human beings. All the verses in the Quran always take us back to Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Like, I'll give you one example.
The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, in this hadith narrated by Muslim, the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, Allah تبارك وتعالى has mercy. His mercy, he divided it into 100 parts. So this is all the mercy of Allah is divided into 100 parts. One part, he put it on this earth. This is the mercy between the mother and her children, between people within each other, the mercy between animals within themselves. Even the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, human beings and also jinn, all the mercy that jinn have between them, that is one part of the mercy of Allah تبارك وتعالى. Even, he said, even the beasts, when the beast is merciful to their children, subhanAllah, he's a beast or she's a beast like the lion or his wife, and then how, subhanAllah, how merciful they are with their own children. This is all the mercy on this earth is one part of the mercy of Allah. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام continues, and he left the 99 of his mercy until the day of judgment to give it to the believers. SubhanAllah. So the 99 of his mercy is for the day of judgment. So what I understand from this ayah, it is not in this life. Sometimes hardship is better for us. When I have this hardship, I will be thinking about it. I will be asking Allah. I will be making dua. I will go back to Allah. If I don't have this hardship, I will be happy in this life, and then I will be busy and I will forget. I'm not gonna keep making istighfar and remembering Allah because I am happy and I will be buying and selling and I will be traveling and going having fun. So this is a human being. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives us the tests to go back to Him because He loves us, because this life is nothing. So Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is saying here, remembering and mentioning the mercy from Allah upon His slave Zakariya. Zakariya became very old. He did not have even one child. And when he had a child, his child got killed and Zakariya was still alive. And Allah said, it's a mercy from Allah. So not everything that we see, we human beings see in our eyes that it is a problem. It is bad. It is the worst life sometimes to me because I am a human being. To Allah, it's mercy. Yes, so always remember, Allah is merciful to me more than my own mother, more than everybody in this life, subhanAllah. This is the mercy of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala. So this is about the mercy. So he said, remembering and mentioning the mercy of Allah, tabaraka wa ta'ala, upon his slave Zakariya. He was taking care of Maryam alayha salam, found food in her room. When he asked her, where did you get this? She said, it is from Allah. Here, he used to make dua before, and he prayed before, and he asked Allah for a child before, but his certainty became more. So it's just like he became more stronger that Allah can give me. He gave her food from the sky, out of nowhere. So Allah can give me a child. So here, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, هُنَالِكَ دَعَى زَكَرِيَّا رَبَّهُ. In that time, Zakariya made dua and asked his God. In here, in Surah Maryam, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. So he asked his Lord secretly. How secretly? It is clear in Ali Imran that he was praying at night. So secretly, all people are asleep. His wife is asleep. No one knows. He is alone in the middle of the night. He woke up in Qiyamul Layl and he asked Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. What did he say exactly? The words that he said in his dua, they are said in the ayat. Allah said exactly what he said. He said, قَالَ رَبِّ هَبْ لِي يَا my Lord, Rabbi, my Lord, habli, grant me, min ladunka, from you. So give me from you, dhurriyatan tayyiba, a good offspring, good children. So he did not ask for children only. He said, good children, ya Allah. So yes, so he asked for certain children, good ones. Now, sometimes people, they say, please, Ya Allah, grant me a boy. If they have a girl, they will say, grant me a boy, a boy, a boy, a boy. And when they have a boy, they have the worst boy. And maybe they will say, please, Ya Allah, give me children, children, children. Please, Ya Allah, grant me husband, 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 husband. But then when she's married, she will say, I wish I didn't get married. She was asking for a husband for 100 years. And when the husband came, I wish I did not get married. You do not ask for a husband. You say for a good, righteous husband. Good, righteous children. Yes. Good house. So when you ask for something, ask for the quality with it. Don't say, please, Ya Allah, grant me a car. Grant me a car which is good and suitable for me. You might have a car and then it is not suitable for you. You need to ask for something which is good. That is very important in dua. Yes, because you might even in dua, you have to be clever. The Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said about Yusuf alayhi salam, when this lady tried to approach him, and she said to him, if you don't give me what I want and surrender to me, I will put you in prison. He did not say, Ya Rab, my Lord, keep her away from me, her and bad manners away from me, protect me from her. He said, Ya Rab, my Lord, I prefer the prison. So he chose the prison. So he said, Lord, prison is better for me than her. So he went to the prison. Even in this point, subhanAllah, and this is said by the Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, when you ask, be clever. You ask for money. Ya Rab, give me money. Money, 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 day and night. Please, Ya Rabbi, grant me money. Grant me money and grant me the wisdom to spend it wisely for the sake of you, Ya Allah. And grant me generosity to spend for the sake of you, Ya Allah. Not only money. Sometimes money will take us to hellfire. Yes. So be clever when you make dua and specify. So he did not say, please, Ya Allah, give me children. He said, give me good offspring, Ya Allah. Innaka sami'u du'a. You are the all hearer. You hear my du'a, Ya Allah. Please, my Lord. So that was his du'a. We go back to Surah Maryam. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, إِذْ نَادَى رَبَّهُ نِدَاءً خَفِيًّا. So he asked his Lord secretly. Secretly means when he was praying at night. And we will come to this in Ali Imran. I just want to say something about Qiyamul Layl. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, first the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in this authentic hadith, Ya ayyuhan nas, O people. So he was talking to people in general. He did not say, O you who believe. He said, O people, everybody, afshu salam, greet each other by saying assalamu alaykum. When you greet someone to say assalamu alaykum, it is dua. You are making dua. You are asking Allah for peace to be upon you. And if you say wa rahmatullah, and the mercy of Allah to be upon you, wa barakatuh, and the blessings of Allah to be upon you. So you are making dua for the person in front of you. So when you are greeting someone, make it as dua. You shake hands your sister in Islam and say assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. And he said afshu salam, spread it. Yes, say salam, greet those who you know that and those who you don't know. Wa at'imu at'am, and feed the hungry. Give them food. Do not leave anybody hungry around you, whether you see them or you don't see them. If they are far away from you, send them food. This is something for the righteous people. These are righteous deeds. Wasilu al-arham, your relatives. Do not cut the relations with the relatives. Who are al-arham? The relatives are the father, the mother, of course, the best, sisters and brothers, aunties and uncles, grandparents, they are all arham. So I have to speak with my uncles, I have to speak with my aunties, call them in Eid maybe, send them messages every now and then. Keep in touch with them. وَصَلُّوا بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّاسُ نِيَامُ. And pray at night when people are asleep. Because the best prayer, the Prophet ﷺ said, after the obligated prayers are the prayers of the night. So he said, pray at night when people are asleep. This is Qiyamul Layl. If we do these things, which are greeting people, feeding food, and keep in touch with the relatives, praying at night when people are asleep, what happens? He said, you will enter Jannah peacefully. You will enter Jannah peacefully if you do these four things. Greeting people, very easy. Anytime you see someone, like whether she's a Muslim or non-Muslim, you see someone in front of you, if it is clear that she's a Muslim, assalamu alaikum. If she's not a Muslim, she was going inside and you are going out, good morning, good evening, hi, smile to her. It's not a problem. Yes, greet everybody. So spread greeting and feed people. We can pay sadaqah to the poor people and it will go to the poor people. Silul arham, very easy. Calling the relatives every now and then or sending them messages every now and then. Qiyamul layl, you can pray rak'atayn. How long is it gonna take? Wallahi, the best feeling ever in this life is when you memorize Quran and recite what you memorized in Qiyamul Layl. This is the best feeling in this life. Wherever you feel happy in this life, it is better than it. This is absolutely the best feeling in this life. When you wake up at night, pray and recite what you memorize from the Quran, new ayat that you memorize. It is the best feeling, subhanallah. And it is a blessing from Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala that this is between me and Allah and no one knows about it. Also, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, عليكم بقيام الليل. Pray at night regularly because it is the way of the righteous people before you. So the righteous people before you, what did they do? They used to pray at night. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. وقربة إلى الله تعالى. You will be closer to Allah تبارك وتعالى when you pray at night. And it takes away from you all the sins, wipes off the sins from your record. وَمَنْهَاتٌ عَنِ الْإِثْمِ, and it will protect you from haram. This is as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said in Quran, إِنَّ الصَّلَاةَ تَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ. Salah, praying, prevents, if I pray properly, it prevents me from haram. Subhanallah, it protects from the haram. Especially قيام الليل, as the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said here, وَمَطْرَدَةٌ لِلدَّاءِ عَنِ الْجَسَدِ. And it will prevent the person, or it will cure the sickness in the body. Allahu Akbar. Subhanallah. And this is an authentic hadith narrated by Tirmidhi and Ahmad. So it is really a cure. So if I am sick, I wake up at night, I get better. Maybe I don't get better completely, but I will be feeling better, that I will be able to do things important in my life. So, and we do not do it only for this matter. You know, some people, they say, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, to have money. Astaghfirullah, 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 to have a house or to be healthy. If I make istighfar or I pray and I do something for dunya, I don't feel the beauty of that ibadah. Yes, I feel the beauty of the ibadah when I do it only for the sake of Allah. I do it to please Allah. I do it to go to Jannah. I do it to be safe in the day of judgment. I do this ibadah to pass the bridge in the day of judgment quickly. I do this ibadah to stand up in front of Allah and He is pleased from me. This is why I do ibadah. So when you are praying, when you are remembering Allah, you imagine Jannah. You imagine yourself in the day of judgment. You don't imagine money and imagine house, or imagine yourself having something in this life. It is better always to be sincere. Do it for the sake of Allah for the hereafter. You do it like this, Allah will give you what you want in this life, subhanallah. But we don't do it only for this life. That's very important, my dear sisters. In another hadith, and this is the last hadith I'm gonna speak about it, because all the prophets and messengers, all the stories that we have been learning about them, they always asked Allah in the prayers, subhanallah. So they were always praying and asking Allah. And the best praying is, or the prayer is, the prayer at night, قيام الليل. So that's why if you wanted something, inshallah, do it with قيام الليل. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام said, أتاني جبريل. جبريل عليه السلام came to me and said, فقال يا محمد. He said to me, محمد, عش ما شئت. Live as much as you want. فإنك ميت. You will eventually die. وأحبب من شئت. Love whoever you want. فإنك مفارقه. You will eventually be separated from them. So this is to Muhammad alayhi salatu wasalam, and it is for each one of us also. This is hadith Hassan, which is authentic by Al-Hakim and Al-Bayhaqi. And then he said to him, وَعْمَلْ مَا شِئْتَ, and do whatever you wanted in this life. فَإِنَّكَ مَجْزِيٌ بِهِ, you will be questioned about it in the day of judgment. So whatever you do today, you are going to be asked about it in the day of judgment. وَعْلَمْ, and know, he wants him to know and us to know. إِنَّ شَرَفَ الْمُؤْمِنِ, the honor and the best ranking of the believer is قِيَامُ اللَّيْلِ, is to wake up at night and pray for the sake of Allah. You don't have to pray all the night. Pray rak'atayn, two rak'atayn, secretly between you and Allah, and don't tell anybody about it. Don't tell your husband about it. Don't tell anyone that you are waking up praying. This is only between you and Allah. This is the honor of the believer. وَعِزَّهُ, and that is his, subhanallah, al-izz is when the person is high ranked. Yes, that is the high rank for the believer. Not Subhanallah, whatever he does in the daytime, it is at night standing up in front of Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala. واستغناءه عن الناس. And when he is sufficient from people. Yes, as much as we can not to ask from people. This is what he is saying. The more I rely on people, the more I will be disappointed and then I will be sad. The more I rely on Allah, the more I will be given. So I need money. I ask Allah. Allah send you the money through someone without asking. Without asking. Yes. Many stories we hear about people in need. Someone brings them, subhanAllah, it comes to them. One example, just quickly, about a lady. Her son was very sick. Her husband, I don't know if he was dead or very, very sick at home. I don't know. So she was like sitting there. Her son is very, very sick. And it is the middle of the night, high fever. She doesn't have money to take her son to the doctors. She doesn't have money for medication. And she was sitting there and thinking, what should I do? I carry him and go out and then they will send me back. Because literally in the Arabic countries, you don't have money. They say to you, go back. If you tell them, like, my son is sick, but I don't have money, they will say to you, it's not our business. So she was wondering, what should I do? What can I do? And it is the middle of the night. Subhanallah. She said, I did not know what to do. I just said, Allah created him. He takes care of him. I don't have money. I don't have anything. It's the middle of the night. So she went and made wudu and prayed. While she was praying, the door was knocking. She was wondering, who is that in the middle of the night? She went, she opened the door. And the man standing up with his bag saying to her, this is the doctor. I am here for your child. She looked at him and she said, excuse me. He said, excuse me, I have a lot of patients on the list. I don't have time to speak. And she was, excuse me, I just want to, excuse me, you. I cannot speak with you. Where is your child? She said, I wanted to ask him, who are you? I did not call you, but he was like, did not give me a chance to speak. And he straight away went to the child. She said, he looked at him, he put water on him, he did everything, he gave me the medication, and he gave her the medication, not only script, because it is the night, it is at night. And then he said to her, this is the bill. She looked at him and she said to him, well, excuse me, now you have to listen to me. I did not call you, and that's what I was trying to tell you. I didn't call you. I don't know who you are. I don't have a telephone number of anybody, doctors or nurses. So, like, I don't know what to say to you. You just come to me like that. He said to her, really? She said, yes. He said to her, but how come you have a sick child with the same symptoms of the person who called? She said, wallahi, I did not call. And they gave me this address. She said, go and have a look at the phone. I did not make any phone calls. She said to him, I am a very, I'm a very poor lady. I don't have any money to give you. He said to me, it's okay, no problem. I will give you extra money. So when this medication finishes, you buy another medication for your child. And I'm gonna go and search for who called me. It is probably someone from this area and I made a mistake and I came here. Subhanallah, someone calls the doctor in the middle of the night. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala makes him by mistake to go to this lady and make him say to her, excuse me, I don't have time to speak. He was in a rush to see the child and give her medication. And when she explains to him, she will be saying, I don't have money. So he felt sorry for her and he gave her money for extra medication. When you ask only Allah, Allah sends to you what you want. Yes, like this is, yes, this is why we are alive. We are alive to please Allah, to ask Allah. So it is not wrong to ask people. Yes, we can ask each other. That's why Islam always encourages us to give each other, to help each other. Yes, وَأَمَّا السَّائِلَ فَلَا تَنْهَرْ. If someone asks you a question, asks you for something, don't say anything bad to them. Listen to them and give them what they want. This is Islam. But subhanAllah, a higher rank for the believer is not even asking people. People will come to you, subhanAllah, and money will come to you from you don't know where. This is subhanAllah, this is the high rank, this is the honor of the believer. When I wake up at night and I ask Allah only and then rely on Allah. Yes, we can ask people, as I said, it is not haram, but subhanAllah, the best is to ask Allah. That is the greatest in Islam. So he did, he woke up at night. فَنَادَتْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَبِ. So the angels gave him the glad tidings when he was standing up praying in his mihrab. So that was, and he was praying at night. Okay, let's go back to Maryam, Surah Maryam. Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala says, so he called his Lord in the middle of the night secretly and he said, قَالَ رَبِّ. Now, another words of his dua. We said the first one, he asked for a good offspring, and now he said, قَالَ رَبِّ. He said, my Lord, إِنِّي وَهَنَ الْعَظْمُ مِنِّي. My bones became soft, because when we grow up, our bones become soft and it breaks quickly, so which means I am getting old, Ya Allah. My bones are soft. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. My head is full of white hairs. So I have a gray hair, which means I am very old and I have a lot of gray hair in my, we call them the white hair. شَيْب. وَاشْتَعَلَ الرَّأْسُ شَيْبًا. The white hairs in the hair, we call it shayb in Arabic. And there is also hadith by the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam talking about shayb. Number one, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, so now if you see one, two, or three, this number, that the little of number of the white hair, the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, la tantifu shayb. Don't cut it and get rid of it. You know, when I was young, I used to hear people saying that when they see someone with white hair, oh, you have a hair, oh, please cut it, remove it. They say, don't cut it because more white hair will grow up. So they say this like, don't cut it because more hair. But in here, in Islam, maybe it is true. If you cut one, you have two coming instead of them. But the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said, don't get rid of the white hair when they are little, of course. فَإِنَّهُ مَا مِن مُسْلِمٍ. Any Muslim have one white hair in his head, when he is a Muslim, of course, except that this white hair, if he leaves it, it will be light for him in the Day of Judgment. In the Day of Judgment, there will be time when everything is dark. That is the time when we will pass on the bridge. We need light on that time. Everyone here, white hair on your head, is light in that time. So, subhanAllah, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala wants you to be happy when you see one hair, oh, it's a light in the Day of Judgment. Not, oh, I'm getting ugly and my hair is becoming... He wants you to be positive all the time. So now when I see white hair, it's a light. It's not a sign of anything. It's a light in the day of judgment. So you should be happy. That's when you have 1, 2, 3. So when it becomes a lot and your hair gets like gray from the number of the, then you can, Islamically, you can change the color. So when the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam saw a man with his head, all of it were gray. So he said to Sahaba, take him and put on him henna. Henna is something natural and beneficial for the hair, not chemicals. So put henna for him and change the color of his hair. And don't make it all pure black. You know, because an old man standing up with black, all black hair, it does not sound right. You know, it's like, what is he doing? Is he trying to make himself very young? Like, it does not suit him. And Islam, subhanAllah, chooses perfection for us. Make it brownish, make it different color, but not very black. That's when we get older, especially. So this is number one, that it is a light for us in the day of judgment. And also the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam said in another hadith, ash-shaybu, white hair, nurul mu'min, it is light for the believer. La yashibu rajulun shaybatan fil Islam. Every man or woman, of course, when Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says man or woman, so it is both of us. Every one white hair you have in your head, it will be for every one hair, one hasana, and you will be lifted one step up. So there is, inshallah, reward for having white hair. So don't panic. And don't feel sad. Yeah. Just when they become a lot, change your hair color and inshallah you will be fine. This is of course Hassan, which is authentic, and it is narrated by Bayhaqi. So this is all about, subhanAllah, it is, Islam is beautiful. So he was saying, my Lord, I have a lot of, like, all my head turned to be gray because of the white hair. And my bones became very soft, so I am very old. وَلَمْ أَكُمْ بِدُعَائِكَ رَبِّ شَقِيًّا. I never stopped making dua for you, my Lord. Shaqi is the person who is unhappy, the miserable person, the unblessed. That's why we call people of hellfire shaqi. One, ashqiya, the plural. So the believer, subhanAllah, is not shaqi. Yes. In here he said, I was never unblessed by not making dua for you. I was always blessed by praying and making dua and asking you, my Lord. And now I am old. وَإِنِّي خِفْتُ الْمَوَالِيَ مِنْ وَرَائِي. Al-Mawali, he was from Bani Israel. So he is talking about those who come after him. So if I die, I don't know what's going to happen to Bani Israel. He is the prophet for Bani Israel. He is the one who teaches them what is right, what is wrong. He answers their questions. He encourages them. So he is saying, I am afraid if I leave these people, what's going to happen to them? Please, Ya Allah, وَكَانَتِ امْرَأَتِي عَاقِرًا, and my wife is does not have children. So the problem was from his wife. She doesn't have children since I married her. فَهَبْ لِي مِنْ لَدُنْكَ وَلِيَّ. So please, Ya Allah, grant me from you وَلِيَّ. وَلِيَّ is a person who inherits another person. So let someone comes, a child from me, to inherit me. And then he said, to inherit me, يَرِثُنِي, to inherit me, وَيَرِثُ مِنْ آلِ يَعْقُوبَ, so he will also inherit what the family of Ya'qub left. So if you go backwards, as I said, you will end up by him from the descendants of Sulaiman alayhi salam, and then from Dawood alayhi salam. And Dawood, if you go back, he will be from Ya'qub alayhi salam. So he said, I want this, my son, grant him to me to inherit from me and inherit from Ya'qub and his family. Inherit what? Inherit prophethood. Inherit righteousness, not inherit money. Because some people think that, let him inherit me and inherit righteousness. Let him take from me righteousness, prophethood. Let him inherit guidance to guide Bani Israel after I die. But subhanallah, he had Yahya, but Yahya died in his life. He got murdered, he got killed, and he was still alive. So what he wanted did not happen. But Allah said, this is a mercy. Yes, it's a mercy from Allah. No one knows how the mercy of Allah happens in this life. To you it is bad, to Allah it is mercy, but you don't understand it. So this is exactly the words that he said, وَجَعَلْهُ رَبِّ رَضِيَّ, make him, Ya Allah, pleased by you. Be pleased from him, Ya Allah, the child that you will give me. Subhanallah, it is already, about 1 hour, but let me say maybe just how the angels came and gave him the glad tidings. I will say the ayat and then I will stop here, inshallah. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, Ya Zakariya, Zakariya, who is calling him? It is the angels. So the angels called him, as Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said in Surah Ali Imran, فَنَادَتْهُ الْمَلَائِكَةُ, the angels called him. وَهُوَ قَائِمٌ يُصَلِّي فِي الْمِحْرَابِ, he was praying at night in his mihrab. إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُبَشِّرُكَ, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives you the glad tidings, بِيَحْيَا, so your son will be called Yahya, John. But yes, so he gave him even the name of the child. So you will have a boy and he will be called Yahya, مُصَدِّقًا بِكَلِمَةٍ مِّنَ اللَّهِ, so he will believe in the word of Allah. What is the word of Allah? Kun, be, and it will be. So he believes in the ability of Allah. He believes in the will of Allah. As Isa, we call Isa is Kalimatullah. Because how was he, subhanallah, created? By Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala saying, Kun ya Isa, be Isa, a human being with a soul without a father. And he was. The same thing, Adam alayhi salam. Adam is also Kalimatan min Allah. Because Allah created Adam without even a father or a mother. He just created his body and then he put the soul in it and said to him, be, and he woke up and he became a human being, subhanallah, as we described his creation. So this is what happened. And then wasayyidan, and he will be a noble in his people. Wahasuran. Hasuran is, in Arabic we call it afif, a person who does not like to have any relationships with women. So he is a very pure person, righteous person. Wa nabiyyan min as-salihin, and a prophet from righteous people. So he is a prophet, he is righteous, descending from righteous and noble and prophets from his family, subhanallah. That these are all the descriptions of Yahya that Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala will grant Zakariya. So this is what the angel said to him. Imagine the angel saying to him, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives you the glad tidings, sends you the good news. You are going to have a child. His name is Yahya. He is Sayyidan. He is Hasuran. Wa Nabiyan min as-salihin. Beautiful, subhanallah. Can you imagine how happy he was to hear the news? And then, subhanallah, he said, قال ربي أن يكون لي غلام. How can I have a child? وقد بلغني الكبر. And I am very old now. So now he is thinking like, it is really rare. How can I have a child? I am very old. وامرأتي عاقر. My wife doesn't have children. She has a problem since we got married. قال كذلك الله يفعل ما يشاء. This is the will of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. He does what he wills. In the other ayat, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, after asking Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala for the child, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala said, Ya Zakariya, we give you the glad tidings of a son called Yahya. لم نجعل له من قبل سمية. No one that we sent before had his name. So there is only one prophet called Yahya. Maybe other prophets which are not mentioned in Quran had the same names, because we only know the prophets in Quran. But there are other messengers and prophets that we don't know. They are thousands and thousands. So maybe there were other prophets who had some same names like some prophets. So he is telling him here, Yahya, who had no one had his name before. So that is only for him. قال ربي أن يكون لي غلام وكانت امرأتي عاقرة وقد بلغت من الكبر عتيا. The same things. How can I have a child when I am old and wife does not have children? He said to him, that is هو علي هين. This is easy for me to do. Allah تبارك وتعالى is telling زكريا, this is easy for me. هو علي هين وقد خلقتك من قبل ولم تك شيئا. I created you, Zakariya, and you were nothing. It is not hard for me to give you a child. I created you, I created your wife. It is so easy for me. It is easier to have a child in the womb of your wife, subhanallah. And that's why in another ayah in Surah Al-Anbiya, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ means we cured his wife. So his wife had a physical problem. When Zakariya made that specific dua, Allah said, وَأَصْلَحْنَا لَهُ زَوْجَهُ. We cured his wife for me. Why? Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, إِنَّهُمْ كَانُوا يُسَارِعُونَ فِي الْخَيْرَاتِ. إِنَّهُمْ, him, Zakariya, and his wife. Why did he grant them a child? Because they were both يُسَارِعُونَ. They were hasting. They do very much. They are quickly in doing goodness, الخيرات. وَيَدْعُونَنَا, they call us, they make dua. رَغَبًا وَرَهَبًا. When they are comfortable, or when they are really urging for something, they always ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Like you ask Allah when you are in peace or when you are scared. That is raghaban wa rahaba. Wa kanu lana khashi'in. Because him and his wife were khashi'in. Al-khushu' is when you are humble. When you are humble, Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala gives you what you ask from him. Inshallah, next week we will continue the ayat. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us from those who are quick in doing goodness. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us from those who wake up at night, pray at night secretly without anybody to see us, to recite the Quran, to make dua to Allah, to remember Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us his mercy in this life and in the hereafter. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to be pleased from us, to be pleased from us in this life and in the hereafter. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make this Quran light in our hearts in this life light in our graves when we die, light on the bridge when in the day of judgment. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to guide us to the best manners, to take away from us the bad manners. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to purify our hearts, to purify our hearing, to purify our seeing, to purify our hearts and our tongues and our souls. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us the energy to remember him day and night, to make dua sincerely for him in the daytime and at night. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us the energy and love to recite the Quran every day, to understand it, to practice it every day. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us understand his religion, to make us understand the sunnah, to practice sunnah every day. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to guide us to his straight path, to guide our children, to guide our husbands, to guide all Muslims to the straight path of Islam. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to grant us the energy and love to recite Quran every day, to pray the five prayers every day, to say the adhkar after every fard, and to say the adhkar in the morning and in the evening. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make us righteous, to be pleased from us in this life and in the hereafter, to be with Prophet Muhammad alayhi salatu wassalam in the day of judgment, to go with him to Jannat al-Firdaus without judgment, without going to hellfire even for 1 second. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to give us the energy and love to worship him until we leave this life, to leave this life doing something good that he loves, worshipping him until the last minute of our lives. I ask Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to make the best moment, the best day, the best time, the time when we leave this life, leaving it with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala to be pleased from us. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك. اللهم صلي وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. جزاكم الله خيرا. And may Allah تبارك وتعالى accept from us all our deeds.